Nirvana's Nevermind wasn't an instant smash when it was released in September 1991. But by the time it reached the top of the charts 4 months later, it had already become an icon. Its cutely anti-capitalist cover art and the crushing riffs of the runaway hit Smells Like Teen Spirit signaled a reversal of rock's slick aesthetic bloat, the rise of a new counterculture, and the end of baby boomers' domination of popular tastes. In the decade since it was recorded by a band that at the time wasn't even the biggest group in Seattle, it's come to be seen as one of the most important albums in musical history and has remained a constant influence on generations of young artists. Long before they actually began working on the follow-up to 1989's Bleach, Kurt Cobain considered naming the album Sheep. He even drew a mock-up ad for it, with the tagline, "Because you want to not, because everyone else is." The group initially started work on Nevermind, intending to release it on Sub Pop. But between Sub Pop's financial floundering and the influence of Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon, they signed with Geffen Records subsidiary DGC and started the album over from scratch with new recording sessions. Sub Pop received royalties for Nevermind that the label's owners credit with keeping the label from folding. The song Polly is the only track from the first sessions to make it to the final album. It's the only appearance on Nevermind of former Nirvana drummer Chad Channing, who Dave Grohl replaced between sessions. Kurt Cobain wanted to record with producer Butch Vig, largely because of his work with the Madison, Wisconsin-based sludge rock band Killdozer. But when it came time to choose a mixer, they went with Andy Wallace, who'd previously worked with Slayer. Cobain later complained that it sounded too slick, but both Vig and Wallace insist that he'd been happy with the mix before the album broke. The first two singles from the album were the last two songs the band wrote before recording it. Smells Like Teen Spirit and Come As You Are were both written after the aborted early sessions. Come as you are, as you were, as I want you to be. The initial U.S. release of Nevermind totaled just over 46,000 copies. By the time it hit number one, it was selling about 300,000 copies a week. It's gone on to sell over 30 million copies worldwide. Smells Like Teen Spirit has been covered, sampled, and quoted on recordings by over 100 artists, including Patti Smith, Jay-Z, Paul Anka, and the Muppets.
Here we are now, entertainers.
You're ruining one of the greatest songs of all time!
The band was kicked out of their own album release party by the bar it was being held at for starting a food fight. They moved the party to the apartment of DGC's promotions person for the Pacific Northwest, where Kurt microwaved a gold album that had been awarded to the band Nelson. Something in the Way was originally intended to have a full band electric arrangement that followed the band's trademark loud, quiet, loud dynamics, but Vig convinced Cobain to record it by himself in the studio's control room. The cellist brought in later for overdubs had trouble playing along, since Cobain's guitar is out of tune in the final take. Something in the way. The noise-drenched hidden track that appears 10 minutes after the end of Something in the Way has a name, Endless Nameless. Near the end of the track, you can hear Cobain actually smash a guitar in the studio.